How you doing, everybody? It's Phil from New York Rocks, and we're rocking down here at the Hard Rock Cafe in the heart of Times Square, and we're here with no other than Lawrence Juba. How you doing, man?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you?
Doing real groovy now, man. This is really cool to have you down here. Now, what brings you here to the event here today?
A taxi.
Taxi.
Well, Ken Daschau is my buddy, so yeah, he said, hey, you're going to be on the East Coast. You want to come be on Breakfast with the Beatles? So I made a special trip. Yeah.
It was like early to wake up, right?
Well, you know, in my world, it's like either it's early or it's kind of extended late. I'm never quite sure, you know.
Okay. All right. So the people out there that don't know who you are, they'll know who you are right now. Talk a little bit about your musical career now. You're from where? England?
I'm from England. I grew up in London. I played in Wings from 78 to 81.
Right.
Before that, I was a studio musician. I played, for example, on The Spy Who Loved Me. I did my James Bond twangy guitar thing. I played with the Alan Parsons Project on Tales of Mystery and Imagination. As a studio musician in LA after Wings, I've played on hundreds of TV shows, movies. Played on Dirty Dancing. Right. I played with the Monkees. Mm-hmm. Belinda Carlisle.
You played a lot of scores and TV shows too. You wrote a lot too.
Yeah, well, I played on Roseanne, Home Improvement, Seventh Heaven, even going back to Happy Days.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of stuff and movies like Good Will Hunting, Pocahontas. I even played on the Muppet movie recently.
Really?
Yeah.
That all happened recently, or like
Over a long time.
It was before, like, let's say, when you got involved with Paul.
No, I mean, most of it was after Wings, because when Wings folded, I moved to L.A. Mm-hmm. and really got kind of deeply involved in studio work because I was raising a family.
Right.
And as soon as my kids were big enough, I started putting out solo records and touring.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I do most of the time, is I do about 80, 90 concerts a year around the world as a solo guitar player. And then I do some studio work. I write the occasional score for a documentary or a movie and do a little bit of teaching. I have an iPad app coming up soon, and you know, just stuff like that.
And I know you got some new music coming out, but what I want to ask you first is, how'd you end up meeting Paul McCartney and getting to work with him for Wings?
Well, I first met Paul in the men's room of a studio in North London, but that wasn't what got me the gig. I worked with Denny Lane, who was in Wings, on a TV show. I was playing in the house band with David Essex on his TV show, and Denny Lane was a guest, and he liked my playing and recommended me.
And now when you first got into Wings, you were playing the guitar, but would you play the acoustic, and Denny was playing electric?
I was lead guitarist, so I was playing mostly electric, some acoustic.
Yeah.
And a little bit of bass occasionally, too.
Mm-hmm. Wow, cool.
Yeah.
Okay, what's your fondest memory working with Wings and Paul McCartney? Go ahead.
I think my favorite moment was when we were doing the Campuchia concert in December of 1979. We were doing Rockestra, where we recreated this rock orchestra, and we had like members of Zeppelin and Floyd and The Who all on stage. That was 79. And we were doing Let It Be. And I was used to playing the solo on Let It Be, and so I just stepped forward and started playing the solo, and it's, wait a minute, that's Pete Townsend breathing down my neck, and there's John Bonham, and it's like, wow, you know, I get really to do, cool. How cool is this, you know,
Wow.
And that, oh yeah, that's Paul McCartney over there, you know, yeah.
And it's amazing, man, that you have so much history to you, like, it's...
Yeah, I've done a lot of stuff over the years, and continue to do so.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Now, I heard you're coming out with a new album, you're coming out with some new material. Go ahead.
Well, I have a new album coming out in the new year, a couple of albums. One is a live album with a DVD, another one is going to be called Under an Indigo Sky. It's kind of a late-night, moody album, some jazzy stuff, and... I had it mixed. I mixed it at Capitol Studios with Al Schmidt, who did McCartney's last, like the Kisses on the Bottom album. Very cool. I'm going to do vinyl, too. People keep asking me for vinyl. Yeah.
I was thinking of what I was going to ask you, because I wanted to ask you, have you talked to Paul? Have you worked with Paul recently or anything?
No, I haven't worked with Paul recently. I mean, you know, I stay in touch with him, but no, I mean, that's, you know, it's like I that would be going back, you know, and I'm he's kind of busy and I'm kind of busy.
Well, you're very multi-talented because you do so many different things. You know how to write and
I stay busy.
Yeah. It's really cool. All right, so your thoughts on here today? Did you enjoy yourself?
Oh yeah, it was great fun. It was really worth getting up at 5 o'clock in the morning
really?
For. Yeah.
Well, I want to thank you very much and best luck to you. But I want everybody out there to know and find out how they can find out more about you and tell everybody. Go ahead.
Okay, well, I'm at laurencejuber.com, LaurenceJuber, .com. I'm on Facebook, but I can't be your friend. You can like me, but I got too many friends. On Twitter, I'm OM28LJ. But if you go to my website, you can get all the info.
I wonder why Facebook doesn't know that you can't have too many friends.
Well, because Facebook's really intended for personal stuff. Right. You're not really supposed to run business stuff on a personal page. Mm-hmm. And I have a fan page, but people keep trying to be my friend on the personal page, and we just can't do it. So I'm going to convert it merge it into the fan page eventually.
See, you got to listen to this guy. He knows his stuff. He's a very educated musician right here.
Technology.
I want to thank you very much. A pleasure was all mine interviewing you. Best of luck to you.
All right,
God bless you, man.
Cheers.
You rock, buddy.
Thank you.
You're watching New York Rocks. Who rocks better than us? Nobody rocks like New York Rocks. We rock the best. Peace out.